Amtrak, the year in video, 2007. This was a very good year. It was my 30th year on the railroad. This footage is in silent mode, used with an early Olympus camera. That's why there was no sound. Plus the camera itself, only thing it had 3.5 megapixels, so not the best image quality. The reason it's in here is because it gives you a chance to take a look at the old F tower. Right now we're on sub 1 headed west. On the left is F Tower, which is no longer there. It was taken down during the course of the year in 2007. A lot of deconstruction was done that particular year. They were getting ready for the East Side Access Project, which was coming in. Later in the video, you're going to see some footage of a map that I have of the proposed big dig for the East Side Access. Here we see a Long Island coming line 4. Now we should be going over to Sound. This is approaching the high-speed rail building. Coming in now. Of course, we've already got permission to go into the building, so there's no problem there. This is SNI 1. Two tracks in the building, 1 and 2. SNI, of course, stands for Service and Inspection. As we pull in, the foreman in charge is going to spot the rear of the train. And we are spotted. We're on the move. I'm not sure whether this is train 43 or it's an Empire train. I'm looking up to see what the power unit is on that end. That's an HHP alongside of us, as you can see on the right. To the right, you see Building 2. Building 3 and Building 4, which is partially deconstructed. Building 3, Building 4 was slated to come down to clear the area so they could start the big dig for the East Side Access Project. Notice the windows have all been removed and the interior of the building has been stripped clean. A lot of asbestos in the buildings. They had to do a lot of asbestos removal work. All these buildings were put up in 1910, so all 100-year-old buildings. That white wall you see, that's Building 2, and that's also the commissary. Pulling west. Passing Q Tower. Ralph's giving a brake test right now on his train. Here's the blueprint I was talking about. What you're looking at here is a blueprint for the planned construction of the east side axis at Sunnyside Yard. If we zoom down, you'll see indication of the various buildings. This will be building 3, moving over to building 4. The area here will be the Q-tip, and you'll see some video clips where they're starting the big dig right here, as well as some video when they were destroying the buildings, building 3 and building 4. All of these are the original blueprints, which I believe dated back to 2006. Interesting stuff.
Further east, you'll see building 5 and the powerhouse all the way at the far end where the steam plant were located. Now we're going to take a look at some of the removal of the buildings, as it were. This covered roof was built in 1910. The architecture alone was really quite significant. I had taken photographs of it. I've got them around somewhere, but you could tell they were dated to 1910 because of the way they were constructed. The rivet work, quite nice. And demolition has truly begun here. This building 3, the buildings were all numbered. As you can see, building 4 was demolished prior to the work starting on building 3. Because the footprint for the Q-tip is basically going to be right through where the midsection of building 4 was. That's looking west at building 2. It's almost 100 years of history in this building. That's looking through the building out to one track. There's a train laid down on one right now. You can see it through the gap between 2 and 3. And that's building 5. That'll be going after these two are cleared away. And now you see they're removing the overhead, the cantilevered roof. Can't really notice the workmanship on the supports right in this video, but believe me, they were worth looking at. I suppose I could have edited this down a little bit, but I just found it fascinating to look at. A jackhammer is breaking up the old foundation of Building 4. Most of the buildings had full basements. You know, they all had steam heat. They had probably boiler rooms in the basement. Dig we must. They're getting a start now on the Q-tip area. I'm glad I recorded this video. The company frowned on picture taking, but I've had a lot of positive comments from co-workers that have come across the videos out on my YouTube site who worked at Sunnyside, and very appreciative that a record was kept of the yard and how it changed over the years. Yeah, the map that you saw earlier was actually located in Building 2 in the engineering room. When they were getting ready to demolish Building 2, I went through the building. Everything had been cleared out, but in the one room I found several blueprints that were tacked up on the wall that would show what was planned for the progression. One was a rather large-scale map, indicating the plans to put in the high-speed rail building. That particular blueprint was 5 feet long by, I guess, 3 feet wide. And two smaller blueprints for the east side access for the big cut that was planned. So I took them down off the wall and saved them. Otherwise, they would have been destroyed with the building. And to me, it's a piece of history that deserves to be saved. Thank you. In the background, you see that tower. That was the Apple building. That's a landmark that has since been destroyed. Beyond the buildings in the background, you'd have Northern Boulevard. Is an Empire train that's lying on sub 3. Normally the Empire trains wouldn't go in sub 3. Going in sub 3 means they're going to go in on the high side of the station, which also means that they're going to have to be swung over to a lower rail when they get to New York. Creeping up here on mainline 4, it's an Acela train from Boston. Everything was running mainline 4. There was flooding by the mouth of the tunnel by mainline 2. And I got some footage. You'll see it later. It was considerable flooding, probably 4 or 5 inches above the rail. As a result, everything had to go line 4, which was a bit of a pain because you had to swing trains when you got to New York. Especially the Empire trains, because they would be going up the Hudson, and to do that they'd have to be over on the low side of the station. On the move. Easing out on the line 4. See the water? Getting a little deeper. Getting a little deeper. Look at the rails. The rails are completely under the water. Back on sub 3 again. Here comes a Long Island on line 4. With flooding like that, I mean, that track speed going into the tunnel could be 60 or 70 miles an hour. You don't want to hit an area that's flooded out like that. It's just, you know, potential disaster. This is the interior of Q Tower on the West End. It's Richie, the daylight operator.
Well, I don't know. I mean, Fleisch has got the hole down now on the relief job.
Okay, photographs on the desk. Here we go. The old Pennsylvania Railroad. GG1 on the pit. Engine house. On the move again. Right now we're going under the
to jump over, the Long Island jump over. Well, this has got to be an Empire train. I can hear the diesel. Hear it? Look to the right. You see this brick structure on the right? That's the basement of what had been F Tower. Remember F Tower? We saw that earlier in the video. Well, that's all that's left. We're on Sub 1 right now. And we'll take a look back. F Tower is gone. The staircase up to the automobile bridge was so that the operators could actually walk from up above, come right down to the tower. Had a locked gate at the top. More than likely, this is probably train 19 coming off. I know it's a long haul, I can tell just by looking. Because there's a dining car right there in the middle. And a sleeper out of that. Early morning before going to work, I decided to go out and take a little video. And that's looking south across the yard from the east end. There's the east end diesel. This is swinging a light engine. Coming off the high side of the yard to go in on, I believe, number 2 track to make a hitch. We're now behind the signal, just waiting for the railroad. Watch the switch. The switch just goes over now. Signal should be coming up.
934 on a restricting start at
834. And that is us on a restricting to go east. This is a hand switch here. Building on the left we own by now is the old radio shop. The larger building is building 2. And we're lined for 2 track. You can see the gap where they've remove buildings 3 and 4.
They're ready to go, Johnny. Good go, 934. Thank you.
And that's your cameraman walking back down. I'll bring him back with a hand signal to make the hitch. Incoming phone call. Giving him a hold up to line up to knuckle. Backup. That is a good hitch. East end of the yard, looking west. 36 track all the way over to the left, 34, 32, Citibank building in the distance. This skyline now in 2020, you wouldn't recognize it. It's jam-packed with high-rise buildings. And here you see the high-speed rail building. I have video of this being built back in 97-98, which I'll probably post later. Another look at the yard diesel. Daylight crew hasn't signed up yet. Probably about 6:30 in the morning. Oh, there's a private car, the Hickory Creek. Yes, occasionally I get a little creative. Rail fans are always interested in what the running gear looks like. Passing the high speed rail building. That's your daylight yardmaster talking to his East End crew. This particular day, there was a derailment in the yard. Didn't happen often, but on occasion you'd have equipment that would, for whatever reason, would have gone off the rails.
Well, the one year Patrick ran, I thought she'd have it. She ain't got it now.
Daylight conductor.
Oh,
ah, now we're coming up on the scene of the derailment. There's a P-32 in the background. As we look over, it would appear to be Jersey Transit MU equipment. There's the train master.
We're going 327, guys.
From the looks of things, it went on the ground in the middle, which means that more than likely it picked a switch while they were making a move. In other words, the track shifted for whatever reason, whether it was weight, track conditions, allowing the switch point to open just enough to catch a wheel. So the lead unit is going in on one track, and the following unit is now lined for the adjacent track, and at a certain point it just jumps the rails, and there it is right there. Notice the pantographs coming down. Anything on the ground, you don't want pantographs up. Here's an MU crew making a move on the west end of the yard. More than likely, the conductor stopped him with the buzzer. He's got a signal whistle that he can reach above his head and hit a one to stop, three to come back. Or he brings him back with the radio, which I believe he just gave him the backup. Lovely shot, a seller on its way to Boston. Leaving the yard, from the looks of the tracks, we're going down to sub 2. I didn't get video every single month. On occasions, a whole month would go by and I wouldn't have anything. Or I might have just taken still photographs. I took a great number of still photos, but the video was, hit or miss. If I knew something was going to be going on, like this, demolition of the yard buildings, I tried to get in with my camera to capture that on video. There's the jump over again. Sub 1 to the right, sub 2 to the left. We're on sub 2. And there is all that's left of F Tower. That's actually the basement. That's Long Island coming line 4. This was flagging train 19 out of Sunnyside.
Clear rail zero, but now show it back in the clear zone.
Coming off a 32 track. I do have other videos. I've got videos of onboard videos of locomotives, but I'm not about to post those right now. I mean, I posted them a while back. They drew some interest, but for example, I've got video of the interiors on the HHPs, like this one here, the yard diesel, a little bit of footage up in the tower. This is the last car on the train, looking east as we go under Queens Plaza. Sub 1 this time. When I hired out in 1977, you had sub 1, 2, 3, and 4. At this point, sub 4 had been taken out of service. Well, we're on the move into New York, and we're getting very close to the end of this particular video presentation. I hope you've enjoyed the ride. Feel free to give me a like. If you look quickly as we pull off, you'll see the split D-rails at the end of sub 1 and sub 2. Look at the right-hand rail of the track we're on now. See it? Split derail? That's to prevent a runaway from getting out onto the main line. They can throw that over and derail anything that might be there rolling west it shouldn't be. And on the left is main line 2 right here. And we're passing underneath the Montauk cutoff. Looks like they're doing track work on line 4. Well, once again, hope you enjoyed the video.